In Warner Brothers' 100-year history, few filmmakers cast a longer shadow than Stanley Kubrick.
Kubrick is a great artist, perhaps one of the greatest that the cinema ever had.
Stanley Kubrick was someone that dedicated his life to making films. He lived films. He loved films.
You've got a big surprise coming to you.
The thing about Stanley is I think that he's a filmmaker's filmmaker. You begin to look at his work and you just stand in awe.
I always knew when I was working with Stanley that you would be making something that you'd be proud of and that would last.
No Kubrick film stands the test of time better than 2001, A Space Odyssey. It is impossible to overstate the film's influence.
2001 was for me a life-changing experience because it showed me the possibilities of cinema.
Stanley tried to take a literary work and do it visually without words, and I think he succeeded amazingly well.
This was a film that was imprinted on the consciousness of everyone who saw it and forced them to talk about it and, more importantly, to think about it.
Though he made only 13 feature films in his lifetime, Kubrick's eclectic body of work testifies to his versatility as an artist.
Every single picture is a different genre, a different period, a different story, a different risk.
I was extremely moved by Clockwork Orange because Clockwork Orange goes to the deepest fears of human beings, that they're not safe in their own homes, no matter what.
People get really bound up in the surface of what the movie is, the violence and gang stuff and drug stuff and all that. But the movie is really about the freedom of man to choose his path in life, whether it be good or bad, without any interference from the government.
Every film he's ever made, the craft is impeccable. The lighting, the dolly shots, the zoom-ins on Barry Lyndon.
Barry Lyndon is among my very favorite of his films, the most romantic.
I defy you to name me one Kubrick film that you can turn off once you start it. It's impossible.
You see one frame and you cannot stop watching. And there was always something new and something original.
Though he is revered as a visual artist, Kubrick's films are filled with unforgettable performances.
He wasn't as interested in naturalistic acting as he was in something that surprised him or piqued his interest. That's when he would go, ah, okay, now we're on to something.
There's a famous story, I believe it's Matthew Modine, who said to Stanley, ooh, that felt good, Stanley, that felt real. And Stanley said, real is good, interesting is better.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff. And I'll blow your house in.
I didn't love Shining the first time I saw it. I have since seen Shining 25 times, one of my favorite pictures.
The Shining is hypnotic. I mean, I don't even say I like it. I can't help watching it.
And the genius of Stanley is you can look at a movie of his 15 times, and even though you know what's right around the corner, you'll be surprised all over again. And I don't know anybody else who possesses that kind of magic.
For his Vietnam War story, Full Metal Jacket, the young cast went through a grueling boot camp with Kubrick as their fearless leader.
As a filmmaker, he was a warrior. He was in it for the long haul. He was patient. He was a tyrant. He was kind. He was benevolent.
You could look him in the eyes and not feel intimidated by him, but you constantly felt challenged by him.
Full Metal Jacket remains a favorite of many veterans for its unblinking portrait of the dehumanization of war.
Anybody that's ever been in the military sits in that theater and looks at Full Metal Jacket, it takes them right back to boot camp. They love the film. They eat the film up. It's their film.
Stanley Kubrick was one of the great storytellers of all time, and he used film as his medium to do that, and it was beautiful.
Well, everybody pretty much acknowledges he's the man. I still feel that underrates him.